right. Remember, we have two man
alien
teams
poops.
Here, one child and one parent team. Michelle, go again.
How could we have fucking forgot about that, Alex?
You'd have to really lose focus. Like,
what? In those two moments, you think we forgot that there's two people on a team? Welcome to the show. We're going to watch some kids.
Numbers is a puzzle.
This one is brought to you by Jake's Small Penis.
Can you solve it?
H. Horn.
Plus
Z. Sense. 4 cents. If you can do that, you'll have a chance to win one of these eight.
Buy a shirt.
As we
horse sense. Horse sense? That's what it was.
Concentration.
A little leap.
That little skip.
Because he doesn't like the stairs, so he does a little hop. He does a little hop every now and then. It's the most awkward, like, stairs to walk down.
Thank you, Gene Wood. Good morning, ladies and gentlemen.
More kids.
Welcome again to Concentration. This is the kind of week that makes everyone feel good, children and parents alike. Kids Week on Classic Concentration, in which we
Donald's
are featuring
the
contestants
same kid?
Ranging in age from 8
I was going
to
pull out my wallet and
8-year-old
bet you, but
today.
I don't have my wallet on
I'm
going
to begin by introducing
you
this pretty young lady on my left. Her
I'm
name
team
is
Donald.
Michelle Bush, and the
I'm
happy,
team
proud
Michelle.
Gentleman standing behind her is her father, Mike. Welcome, Michelle.
Thank you.
I bet you your Metro card.
Now, I'm going to make a guess and say
what do I get?
You like going to school.
Your MetroCard
not,
not ripped up.
School, what are some of the things you enjoy doing?
Bad bet.
I like swimming and...
That's about it. You a good diver, too?
Yeah.
What do you want to be when you grow up?
I like swimming and don't ask about my shit, old man.
Well, you're a little young. You've got plenty of time to make up your mind. You ready to play our game?
Yeah.
Okay, let me introduce your opponent. This young gentleman is Donald. Let me. You got to help me with the pronunciation of your last name.
Matade.
Donald Matade. Welcome, Donald. I'm happy to meet you.
What is it? Matade?
Matade.
Hi. Tell me a little bit about yourself.
Stay away from my mom, Alex.
I hate swimming.
Up in the river.
Yeah? What's your favorite subject? Do you have one?
Math.
Math. Are you good at it?
Yeah.
Well, math plays a part on our game, as
you
know,
said no.
You have to remember numbers.
Math
you know
doesn't play,
play
a part
math.
In your
right,
game,
you
Alex.
Are here to make the matches on the board. And
does Alex think memorizing is math?
So let's get to work right now. You
so.
Play the piano?
What?
Sometimes.
Michelle,
that's the
can
prize?
You play the piano?
Yeah.
I'm hoping
good,
that's the prize.
Because take a look over here and you'll
what
see
what does Donald mean by sometimes?
The young Chang, classic grand with his
he's not
white
always playing the piano.
Materials and built to last, furnished by young
doesn't
Chang.
Do you?
Alex.
I like her.
Yeah, she has fun with it.
Piano very well, but she's good on chopsticks. Now you can find that piano on the board, hiding behind
but she's
door number
good
20.
On chopsticks.
It's called a baby grand piano.
20.
All right,
the dad just
know,
whispered in Michelle's
wherever
ear. 20.
You see those prizes. Keep
Jimmy,
them in your mind.
That would be
now,
cheating.
Parents,
he did look.
Open up two more
he
doors
didn't say 20. He said good luck,
puzzle.
Babe.
11 doesn't reveal too much. 12. We're going to open up two more doors and show them where you
look.
See those prizes. Keep them in your mind. Now, for your parents, we're going to open up two more doors
whatever.
And show them two pieces of the
why are
puzzle.
They showing back to back?
Reveal too much. 12 reveals
that's how
a
it
bit
breaks
more.
Sometimes.
Michelle, you're going first. Make a selection of two numbers.
I like to see what's behind door number 3.
Number 3. Let's take a look. Wild
wow, Michelle. Way to go. Good start. All right, stop bending down all the time.
No matter what
stay out of her ear, Dad.
He's encouraging his daughter.
I'd like to go for the piano under 20.
Hey, she's pretty smart for an 8-year-old. Going for the baby grand
that's
piano.
Not that smart for an 8-year-old.
It's the only one she knew.
Natural average competence.
Would have been yeah. At number 10. So we'll put that prize into position. Dad just heaved a big sigh of relief saying, oh, Michelle, thank you. That's a great prize. Now let's
no,
see if he can
didn't.
Do his work by solving the puzzle. Mike, take a look at these three pieces.
Michael and Michelle.
No, it's too early, Alex.
I figured it would be. All right, Michelle, back to you. You select two more numbers.
I think I like to see what's under 22.
Interesting. Oh, wow. Michelle's a goddamn yeah. Ringer. Did he whisper in his ear again?
Michelle? I don't know.
Sometimes, huh?
I don't give a shit about what you say.
So you just got to go for anything up there. Maybe something that would help
I'd like
your dad
to see
solve
what's
the puzzle.
Yeah, cut him off.
19, all right. We've got some patio dining furniture.
She hates it.
She doesn't even know what that is.
It's over there at number 7. So that's another prize for your side of the board up here. And Dad gets another shot at solving the puzzle. Take a look.
Poops.
No.
All right, remember we have two men
alien
here,
poops.
One child and one parent team. Michelle, go again.
How could we have fucking forgot about that, Alex?
You'd have to really lose like, focus.
What? In those two moments, you think we forgot that there's two people on a team?
All right, remember we have two man teams here, or one child and one parent team. Michelle, go again.
I'd like to see what's behind number one.
The left-hand corner. That's
green take. 17.
And 25.
25. Diagonally opposite. A
diagonal
player.
Corners.
That's a fun prize. But
alley-oops.
So we go to Donald. He gets his first try.
Number eight, please.
Number eight. Is that a good one? That's a roll-top desk.
No.
Number five.
Number five.
Not a good one, Alex.
Long and short of it, no.
No match for you, Donald, so we go back to Michelle.
I'd like to see what's under six.
Did he tap her six times?
Electronic typewriter.
I'm onto this.
And five. That makes it
dude. I think he tapped her six times. I'm calling big time cheat.
I have a video of your dad's favorite today, and I bet you your dad's favorite every day. Let's show two more
shots
pieces
fired
of
at our
puzzle.
Siblings for no reason at all.
Mike?
I'd like to guess. Right. High hopes.
Is it high hopes? Oh, boy.
Shit, man.
You saying alien poops?
No, he didn't say that.
It's exciting, isn't it?
Yeah.
Oh, and Mike did his work. Nice going. Oh,
Donald got a face rub.
Look at this. Nice going.
It's okay, son.
Donald,
they cheated.
You know, that was a bad break because you only got one chance early on. Michelle started like a house on
dude,
fire. She hit those
so
two
Michelle started like a house on fire.
You only got one chance early on.
That old kid term.
Skill, it's luck. And she had a lot of luck today as well as skill.
What the fuck, Trebek?
It was a short visit. Only skill, it's luck. And she had a lot of luck today as well as skill. But
now he's dissing both kids. Yeah.
I know it's going to be a
disappointment. Oh, they just kissed on the mouth.
Today as well as skill. But it was a short visit for you, so I know it's going to be a disappointment. But
people
you know,
do that.
We've got some prizes for you backstage, all right? Okay, let me show the folks at home how Michael solved that puzzle so quickly. Boy. We had just a little bit of the H showing, I think, but he came through with the H and all the arrows pointing at the eye of the needle. So there's the high, and then we've got all the arrows down here pointing at the hope, and we add the PS on the end of it for hopes.
That's pretty easy.
Hopes.
And do you think they did an easy one first round because they want to make sure they hit the time on the second round?
I don't know.
I think so. Because the first kids episode we watched, they, like, ran out of time. Last episode.
Of course, during the course of the game, if it had gone on a little longer,
we didn't
sure
get much of a chance
better.
To talk. Oh,
all right, thank you very much for being with us.
Oh, you didn't
all
have
right,
fun.
Michelle and Mike.
You didn't do anything.
You won some big prizes. Well, here's Gene to tell you all about
it. An electronic typewriter.
I'm running, you didn't think Michelle would win.
Dining furniture. The Duetto, offering casual dining for two. Ideal
I like
for balcony,
that.
Small patio, or kitchen crafted of tubular steel with the exclusive Emu finish.
Ideally, that would be in our kitchen.
Glass tabletop
why
by Emu.
Is the one
and
side
of course,
the chair longer
the
than the other?
Beautiful baby grand piano. A prize package worth, listen to this number, $8,600.
He just doesn't know what to do with his hands.
Yeah.
And Mike was just telling me that... This is terrific.
Hands are constantly moving.
Prizes they can really use. Both Michelle and Mike
dude.
Play the piano. They needed the patio
I think he's
furniture.
Going to
and I have a feeling
you
could use a new car, too,
think
right?
So?
Sure
yeah.
Can.
Well, let's find out if you're going to be a winner on that score.
If he doesn't,
on concentration right after
I think we're going to see, like, an air punch.
Michelle, you probably don't have a driver's license yet, do you?
Yeah.
I bet classic. You'd be really excited if your dad won one of these cars. It could be this white one down at the bottom. That's the Pontiac LeMans.
That one sucks,
that one
though.
Sucks.
Next, the next step up, we've got the Volkswagen
also
Golf.
Sucks.
Sucks,
the
but
Nissan
I get it.
Sentra.
All right.
Kind of boring.
Same thing.
Ugliest color you could get.
Comes with the woman as your new mom.
The Toyota Corolla.
Sucks.
The Mitsubishi Mirage.
Cool in its
right
time.
At the top, we've
yeah.
Got that Jeep Comanche.
The still winner.
Pickup truck. Michelle, do you guys have in your family kind of a lucky expression, you know, when you want to wish somebody good luck? What do you say? Just good luck?
Yeah.
What do you say?
Do well, don't
who has
up,
that?
All right?
Zach,
what's
your family's,
family's
lucky expression when you guys want to have good luck?
Break a leg.
That's not yeah. Your family's.
No.
Kind of the stage.
His
people.
Family could use it.
We didn't invent it.
Could be his family's. What's your family's?
Good luck. Break a leg. Everyone, leave in the comments below your yeah. Family's, specifically just your family's expression for good luck.
All right. Okay, Dad.
My mom used to say, like, don't be a fucking idiot.
And the same thing applies to you as all of our players in the winner's circle.
Stick together and
you will. Gotcha, Mom.
Stay together and you will survive. That's what I always say. That's when we were kids.
Two.
No match.
Three. Four.
No match.
Ooh.
Two.
Four?
Four.
Okay.
He's a gamer.
I mean, you get one in the first.
No match.
Four.
Seven.
Three?
No match.
One. Seven.
That's a match.
Eight. Nine.
No match.
10. 11.
No match.
5. 11.
Guy's a gamer.
12. 8.
8.
No match.
13. 14.
No match.
8.
14.
That's a match.
15. 3.
No match.
12. 15. I mean 15.
That's a match.
9.
That wouldn't count in the game.
13.
No match.
10. 12.
That's a match.
13.
Oh! Mike!
It is so tough, I know. I've said this time and time again on our program, especially for champions who are up here for the first time, even with the 50 full seconds. But you came so very close.
Dude, we watched the Tournament of Champions. They were all pretty good.
Yeah.
Like, we haven't seen someone really do it.
Yeah.
You know something, Michelle? Do you remember the total that Gene Wood gave a while ago? Of the prize,
$8,665. Of course, I remember, Alex. I'm a little kid.
$8,659. That sounds like a lot.
Close.
Yeah, it is a lot.
Sound like a lot? I have no idea, Alex. No idea how
I haven't lived a day in the real world.
I don't know what money means.
I don't know what patio furniture is.
Patio dining furniture.
All right, two new teams to introduce.
Whoa, I thought that was the second match of the episode.
Her name is Kristen Ernst, and she has her grandmother, Janie, with her. Hiya, Kristen.
Her grandmother?
So that is her grandmother.
For just a moment, all right? Janie, tell me a little bit about Kristen. What is special about your
she's
granddaughter?
She's spunky.
Putting you on the spot, I know.
Well, she's a very special girl. She's very intelligent.
Is she good in school?
That's the energy I want to give off.
Straight A's.
Oh, yeah. What's your favorite subject, Kristen?
Straight A's.
Did the lighting change?
A lot of the kids seem to like math. Well, good luck to you on the program today. Your opponent is this young man. His name is Jonathan Gorney. Hello, Jonathan.
Gorney.
You got your mom here, Valerie. Hello. Welcome. Jonathan, you have any brothers or sisters?
Yes, I have. I think 5 brothers and 3 sisters.
Wait a minute. You think? Well,
Jonathan.
Nine in the family. That's hard.
I'm in a business meeting with Jonathan.
Yes. You get along well with all of them?
And he knows he's smarter than me.
No one beats up on you, and you don't beat up on
anyone
else?
No. He gets pretty frustrated because I make him laugh twice, and he's mad about it.
I hope you're going to have a lot of fun with us today.
He's like, I can't believe that guy made me.
He pisses in your coffee, too.
And Kristen, one of the prizes that we've got for you in this game.
Marjorie,
demonstrate. Yeah, you don't. Oh, okay. What have nightmares?
Laser Q pinball game with all new digital stereo, advanced speech and special effects light show, and Space Age software. Laser Q, Alex.
Kristen, how many brothers and sisters have you got? Or do you have any?
What's going on with Charlie Wood? What's his name?
Eugene Wood.
Well, this prize would be fun for you and your sister, but I have a feeling that Jonathan would get more enjoyment because he's got so many brothers and sisters. But you're going to find that pinball machine on the board behind door number 10. And now for Mom and Grandma, let's open up 2 more doors. Number 4.
Grandma looks like an SNL skit.
22. Jonathan, you're in the challenger's seat, so you'll make the first selection. Off you go. 2 numbers.
May I please have number 13?
All right. Right in the middle, number 13.
Very polite.
Microscope.
Couldn't do that with telescope?
Number 2.
No. Scope.
Brass.
No telescope's less letters.
Pick 2 numbers.
Number 8.
Oh, my God, kids.
Yeah.
Like, God.
Dick.
Number 21.
21. 1,000 gallons of water. That's not too exciting, is it, Kristen? No, not for you. I know. All right. Well, no match. Let's go back to Jonathan.
Please have number 3.
Sure.
We deliver it right to your house.
You saw that a little while ago.
And 13.
13 in the middle.
Oh, good job.
Good going, Jonathan.
Let's find that other 1,000 gallons of gasoline.
By solving the puzzle. A lot of pressure on you, huh, Valerie? All right, take a look and see if this is enough to help you do it.
Not yet.
Not
wardrobe
yet.
In the hole.
Back to you, Jonathan.
My foot's up number 19.
19. That's 1,000 gallons of
16.
Gasoline.
And number 21.
21 is another 1,000 gallons.
Can you believe it?
Finally, Mom, we got all that gasoline Dad's been dying for.
Okay, that prize up there, and for Mom once again, the pressure mounts as she has an opportunity.
Do you think in the history of the show,
see if you can do it, Valerie?
1,000 gallons of gasoline has ever been taken?
All right, Jonathan, back to you.
No.
Can I please have number one?
Sure.
Yes.
Electric.
Is the only item they have.
I guess I'll take the gasoline, Alex.
Let's see if we have a match there. A wild card makes it an automatic match.
Do you think the mom or the dad is hotter?
Natural match to the electric
Jonathan?
Motor was right
Dad.
Next to that.
You think so?
And now you've got three prizes on your side, Jonathan, and your mom gets
but he doesn't know it.
Three more pieces of the puzzle.
The dad or Jonathan?
The dad.
The more the better.
The dad is hotter than the wife, but he doesn't
know it. He doesn't know it.
Okay.
Not yet.
All right, Jonathan.
Not yet.
But if he went to, like, the right barber and stylist, he'd walk out.
Vacuum cleaner.
God, that's so boring for a little kid.
Vacuum cleaner.
Kid's a freak.
Boy, Kristen, he's on kind of a roll right now, isn't he? You think you're ever going to get back into this game?
I hope so.
So do I. All right, well, let's see. Right
so
now,
do I?
We put prize up there, and down here for Valerie, his mom, we open up two more doors.
Pear, four pear, four apple.
Not yet. Okay, Jonathan, pears. Keep going.
My plus have number... six.
Wardrobe, your pair.
And a number 10.
Well, that's a cool
Pinball
prize for
machine.
A kid. How'd he get that?
Rolling.
I had no trouble remembering where that one was, did you?
That's what they showed him before the match.
Oh, you do, huh? All right, you got five
Jesus,
of them up there
Jonathan.
Now,
have a day.
Kind of exciting.
Mom, why don't you
excited.
Pick them up?
I wonder if you think she knows the solution to the puzzle.
Yes.
That's funny.
Yes, yes.
She
okay.
Moved his
well,
head,
let's
yes.
open those two doors and ask her to solve it.
Closed for repairs.
Is it closed?
Wow,
for
that's cool.
Yes, it is. All
that
right.
was good.
Well.
They're happy.
Congratulations, you two. Jonathan, you were just great. And Valerie, you were good too. Came through when you had to. Kristen, I know. I'll
Jesus,
talk to you in a moment. Right now,
sweeps,
let me show the folks
man.
At home how we solved that one. We've got all this clothing here, so we've got clothes plus the D, so it's closed. Four, re plus two beautiful green pears, not ready to be eaten. Closed for repairs. And that's good news for Jonathan and Valerie, who are going to join me down here.
Pear analytics there by Trebek.
Kristen, you ran into a lot of good luck for Jonathan. He just never lost control of the board. So
grandma came out for that.
Give your grandma a chance to solve the puzzle. But I hope you had a good time, and I hope you enjoy watching yourself on concentration. Thank you and goodbye. Whoa, hang
we
on
got
there,
two.
Grandma almost
Valerie.
Went down.
We got two shutouts, huh?
Someone's fallen before, right?
The pinball
Can we find
machine,
that?
Which I have a feeling Jonathan is going to be most excited about. But you know yeah. your mom's going to have a chance to win a brand new car.
Hey,
right,
you
we'll
know
see
what?
If she can do that
Dude,
when we come back.
The name right. Valerie, I think, fell out of fashion, and it shouldn't
Welcome
have.
Back, folks.
Valerie's still around.
Situation here on Kids Week on concentration.
She spells
and
it weird.
The fact that when people appear Valerie. On the they're usually going to be nervous, so we expect that. We
Let me go to my favorite site.
Valerie, it's been a minute.
Were you more nervous for
baby
Jonathan
names.
Or for yourself today?
He's much better player than I am. For me, I'm more nervous.
But you came through like a trooper when you solved that
Trebek.
Close for repairs. When did
Valerie was through? Most popular in the 80s.
Evan, I don't know.
Just a lucky guess?
It's been waning.
Right.
It had
well,
a steep
made
drop.
For an exciting moment, and now
or maybe it was most popular
the possibility of winning a brand new
in 1960.
Car. You two
it was
wind
65th.
Up this Jeep Comanche pickup truck.
Right
or
now
the
it's 150th.
Right next to it. Let's keep moving down. The next one is the Toyota.
And you know what Polo. I'd say?
Then the Plymouth Reliant.
I think other names just got more popular.
The Nissan Sentra.
Yep.
The Volkswagen Golf.
Only so many names out there.
And finally, right
What's your favorite
the
name?
I think there's more names in the bunch.
What's your favorite
cars, and
female name
children, I think
that starts with a V?
Would come in handy, right?
I'm sure.
Okay.
Virginia.
Jonathan, you're not going
Valerie,
to participate in this.
Vicky.
It's all up to Mom, and I know you want to wish her luck. Here are the
Venetia.
15 numbered squares, Valerie. What
Currently,
you want to do
Valerie.
Match seven cars within the allowed time. Remember that the eighth car is up there all by itself, and it may confuse you a little. Don't let that happen. Here is the clock. 50 seconds. Good luck to you. Atta girl, take a deep breath, and off you go.
One, two.
Le Mans, I mark.
Three, four.
No match.
Five, six.
That's
wow.
Seven, eight.
No match.
9, 1, 9, 2, 9, 10, 11.
No match.
12, 13.
No match. She blew it.
14, 2.
And she's lost now.
2, 9, 2.
Two.
Okay.
That's a match.
3, 15.
No match.
8, 14.
No match.
7, 4, 10.
No match.
1, 15. 15.
That's a match.
4, 13.
That's a match.
10. 3.
No match.
Damn.
You started to get the hang of it towards the end. You were moving towards what looked like a win.
Like Veronica.
Oh, I like Veronica a lot.
In the early going, you didn't make
Vienna.
What about
I like Vanessa.
I like Vanessa too. You like Violet?
You won some good prizes.
I'm okay with Violet.
Zeta.
$4,485.
Venus.
No, I don't like Venus.
Your pinball machine. You're going to let your brothers and sisters use it, I hope.
Maybe.
Probably Vanessa.
I think Vanessa's my favorite, too. Come back right after this with some news about a very special upcoming event. Victoria. Concentration.
Kids are helping the parents win some terrific prizes on Concentration this week. But next week, a very special event. The adults are going to be playing all by themselves, and there will be something special added, and that is an around-the-world trip for the champion who comes to the winner's circle and wins a car in the shortest possible time. So
what the hell does an
around-the-world
trip mean?
Will be worth about $9,000 or $10,000.
Around the world trip.
In addition to a car
like
worth
a cruise? That blows.
$12,000 or $14,000.
Amelia Earhart,
you
died.
But you be sure to tune us in tomorrow for lots more excitement right here on Concentration. And thanks and congratulations to the two of you again. So long, folks.
A member of our studio audience will receive Cutco's
Cutco.
I like knives.
Cutlery company. Cutco.
Sometimes you get a knife, like the bagel, the bread spreading knife, that fat one they just showed. When you actually use that, and you're like, oh my god, this does work better. Or like the really ridged bread knives when it does. When you use a knife for what it's intended and it does noticeably work better, that's cool. It's like, wow. People did this.
Make every day special with the FTD. Celebrate bouquet along with
Blossom. No one cares. Mr. Guy. Leave your favorite V name for girls.
V name, your family's rallying cry.
And
last hat you wore.
And your guess at Zach's home address.